Our focus is on cutting edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businessmen.
I'd like to say, I think Abhinav shared a beautiful perspective what excellence means. He's somebody who's lived that, and today we are also grateful and happy that we have a sports minister who himself is a champion, who started his passion. We are seeing such great initiatives in sport with people from such diverse fields coming up and helping sport. I'm sure the future will be great for all of us. Having said that, and being part of the sporting ecosystem for many, many years, I think sporting excellence is something which is very critical, and Abhinav has articulated it superbly well to say that result-oriented mindset and excellence-driven sports mindset is very important for us as a nation which wants to drive sporting excellence to the highest levels. For me, my journey into sports after 25 years started about 3 years ago in a different direction. I was coaching a young girl who was about 13 years, and I threw a shuttle to her from 5 feet away, and she dropped it. And I was a little annoyed, and I almost walked out the next time she missed the shuttle. She, at the end of the session, came up and said, "Sir, teach me how to catch." And that for me was earth-shaking in a way, because never in my life had I thought that I would need to address a question like this. When I introspected, I realized that what we think is natural is not natural. We've been fortunate that nature taught us a lot of the things. We grew up jumping in puddles of water, we climbed steps, we climbed trees. Some of us were fortunate, we jumped, we threw stones at mango trees. We were all in a way brought up by nature. But there's a whole new generation which is actually, thanks to our growth thinking, has thought only about alphabetically growing up. If alphabets, words, sentences was alphabetical literacy, and if numbers and additions and subtractions and multiplications in that progression was numerical literacy, there's something like called physical literacy which we have been falling out on. In the last few years, we've grown alphabetically, numerically, but we have lost physically, and we've lost a lot more, because this whole generation goes in as less confident kids, because when you're not physically up there and you have to think about doing any physical work, then it affects you confidence-wise, it affects you health-wise, it affects you team-wise and every other way. So I think it's very important that sport needs to look at champions. Today, at the cusp, when we are talking about taking sport to many, many people across the country, it is important that we also take care of each one of them. It is not only about winners. Sport is much beyond. Sport is when everybody becomes a winner. And the only way that is going to happen is we look at self-referral as the biggest thing. We can try to be the best in the world, but I think to be the best of what we can be is what I think sport's biggest success will be. So I think for us, the journey starts at the school level, where a physical education teacher is thinking not about winning the championships, but thinking about ensuring that every kid in school, every kid in class is moving towards saying that I have a positive experience out of class and I will do physical activity to keep myself fit in my entire life. That's the journey which we would want this country to take. We want a country which is more physically active and which feels not rejected out of sport, which feels positive towards sport, which sees that somebody else can win. I'm not competing against him alone. I'm also competing against myself. And when I win against myself, that's the best victory I'll have. With that mindset, if sport were taken, then there'll be all champions and we'll have a lot more people playing. So we need everything. We need everybody to play sport. We need some people to take us to the highest level, but also the people who are going out of professional sport also have to go out with a positive mindset. That's the simple message which ELMS has, and it's great to have people whom I have mentioned along with Pradeep Sir who's here. To be part of such a group is amazing. The kind of energy which it brings, the kind of mindset which we all have, and hoping and praying that we can make a difference in this whole country. This will impact the entire country is what my belief is. And we've done some work in Andhra and Telangana in the last few years, and my belief is that this has a chance to become a huge, huge impact. And I wish and pray that years from now, we'll all be proud of the work. Thank you very much.